Hello all, Dr. Alsop here, and we are getting to talk about one of my all-time favorite things, sutures. These immovable fibrous joints of the skull are literally all over the place, basically anywhere where you have two bones meet in the skull. We are not going through all of them, but we have quite a few to get through, so let's get started. All right. My first recommendation for any time you look at an image, particularly in an assessment situation like the practical, is to try to figure out what view you are looking at. So here we are looking at a superior view, or the top of the skull. This is going to be anterior, and this will be posterior. Next, when trying to better identify osteological structures, I like to identify which bones I can actually see before breaking down the structures. So let's ID the bones here. So the most anterior bone is going to be the frontal. And you see no suture kind of going down the midline here, so you know you're looking at that unpaired frontal bone. Next, you can see the paired parietal bones. And then you can see a little peak of the occipital bone back here in the posterior region. Now, where these bones meet, you will have joints, and these joints are referred to as sutures. First suture we will discuss is the coronal suture, which is sometimes referred to as the frontal suture. And it's going to be the meeting point between the frontal bone and the paired parietal bones. So here's your coronal suture. Think of it as kind of where a tiara would sit on your head. All right, the suture here, kind of running down the midline, will be the sagittal suture. And it's going to be between the paired parietal bones. Now, I hope you have noticed that the coronal and sagittal terms are also used in anatomical plane terminology. So the coronal plane is that vertical plane that passes longitudinally through the body and can divide into anterior and posterior halves, whereas the sagittal plane would divide the body into right and left portions. So because I'm an osteologist in background, I often go back to remembering where these sutures are located when thinking about the planes. You may work the opposite way, whatever works, but it is nice to have multiple ways to think through these terminologies. All right, so back to the sutures. Between the parietal bone, or parietal bones, excuse me, and the occipital bone is this complex lambdoid or lambdoidal suture. All right, let's look at some of these from a different view. Here we are looking at a posterior view of the cranium. Let's ID the bones. You have your two parietal bones here, and you have a much better view of the occipital bone, or that posteriormost bone here, which makes sense. You can see a much clearer view of the lambdoidal suture and its complexities between the parietal bones and the occipital, and then of course you have that sagittal suture between the parietal bones. All right, let's move to a lateral view of the skull. You can see quite a few more bones here, which makes sense because you have some of the facial bones in this region. And where those bones are going to meet, you'll also have sutures. So let's get established that this is anterior here and posterior over here. That makes sense. The anterior, you're going to have the orbits and the teeth. And let's ID some of the bones. Here is your frontal bone. Here is the left parietal bone. The occipital bone is back here. And let's ID a few new bones that we haven't talked about in this session yet. Here is the temporal bone, that fairly nondescript portion here, and then fairly complex portion over here. You have a little bit of the sphenoid bone. And here is the zygomatic bone, often colloquially referred to as the cheekbone. Now for the sutures we have already identified in other views. Here is that coronal suture between the frontal bone and the parietal bone. And you can see some of the lambdoid suture here between the parietal bone and the occipital bone. Now, mainly between the parietal bone and the temporal bone, you will have the squamous suture. So this is the squamous suture. You can see that this suture is not as complex as some of the other ones, so not as squiggly as the others. I think that's a nice way to identify that. You will also have another squamous suture, the right squamous suture on the other side. Where the sphenoid meets the temporal bone or the squamous suture is the sphenosquamous suture. And lastly, the small suture here between the zygomatic bone and the frontal bone is going to be the zygomaticofrontal suture. So a very long name for a very small suture. All right, last view, which is a full anterior view of the skull. Let's identify the bones you can see here. Here is that large frontal bone that is forming the bulk of the forehead region. You have the two zygomatic bones here, or your cheekbones. These two small bones that are going to form the bridge of the nose are your nasal bones. And lastly, these large bones that house your maxillary or upper teeth are going to be your maxillary bones or your maxillae. So where the maxilla meets the zygomatic is going to be the zygomaticomaxillary suture. So you'll have one over here on this side as well. And where the frontal bone meets the paired nasal bones, you will have the frontonasal suture. All right, so that is enough suture fun for now. Once you get down the bone identification, suture identification usually isn't so bad. All right, as always, please reach out to me if you have any questions, and we will talk soon.